One of the most beautiful things about making this film was the small crew that we had. It was me, it was Michael who was directing and filming it, it was Raz who was doing the boom, and it was Mel who did the makeup.
This is a no-budget thing, so, you know, I was just basically begging some friends to work on the project with me. And with the intent of just trying to make something short, but high impact and interesting, that we can put on the internet for free for people to see, because we just want to put something out there that maybe get some different people's attention and maybe helps open up opportunities for us to do bigger scale projects.
We had a small crew, so we all had to wear many hats when we were out there. And with a small crew, you also don't have the luxuries of having permits or telling people, hey, you can't be walking by here because we're shooting the film. So there were challenges in that area, but at the same time, when you have a small crew like that, you really develop a strong bond with each other, and you gain a trust, and you can dialogue with each other and give each other advice and feedback on how to improve. So there wasn't this hierarchical feel where anyone was at the bottom of the totem pole. Everyone had important pieces to say to make the film better. And that's one of my favorite things about working on these small sets and working on these independent films, is that it's a really collaborative effort.
I've been doing a lot of cinematography work over the last few years, and as a result, I ended up opting to naturally direct and be the cinematographer in this film, partly to just keep, again, the number of people down, but also because I thought it would be an interesting challenge to take on. It's certainly not the kind of thing I would do for a large project. I have always worked on my other short films with a cinematographer, and having now been the director and the cinematographer for a project like this, I'm like, yeah, I wouldn't do it for anything bigger.
Acting in a film with no actors and no dialogue is really tough, especially for me, since I'm just beginning at this whole acting thing. It wasn't really, though, until I was on set that I really got a good grasp of the character. It was one of those moments where I actually had to be in the moment to really feel what was going on. I kept reading it and getting good ideas, but once you're on set, your perspective on things change a lot as far as where you're going to go with the character and how you're going to play out the scene. Especially once you see the location, you have this location in your mind of how it's looking like, but once you actually see where you're shooting, that definitely changes up the way you play out the scene. In that situation, when you don't have any actors and you don't have much dialogue, you become more dependent on your director.
This is typical me making a movie. 3 years, I haven't directed a film, a narrative film. One day I picked the film, despite the weather.
Yeah.
It wouldn't be indie without it.
No.
We're just finishing up one of the last shots of the fourth scene, and it started pouring out, so we had to run back in the pavilion. But after that, we just have one more scene to shoot, and we're golden, so that's pretty good.